Hello, I'm Edmund Edward, bookkeeping commerce teacher at Turkish Marriage Schools Arusha. Today I'm going to teach you bookkeeping, form one topic, trial balance, with a subtopic, preparation of trial balance. You are welcome. As I've told you, today I'm going to teach you trial balance, but trial balance is a connection with a double entry system. So if you haven't started double entry system, make sure you find your time to read what the meaning of double entry system, how to prepare double entry system, and how to balance the account in double entry system. Student, now we are going to start with our new topic, which is trial balance. But before giving you my definition, anyone who can define what is the meaning of trial balance? Very good. Now, let me give you my definition. Trial balance is a bookkeeping or accounting report that lists the balances in each of an organization's general ledger accounts. As I have told you, in order to understand the trial balance, you have to revise on the double entry system. In double entry system is that topic where you can find the list of balances on each ledger account, or double entry you can say is a statement used to show the list of balances, which balances, the balances which you have obtained in the double entry system. After seeing the definition or the meaning of trial balance, let's discuss on the advantages of trial balance. Advantage number one, trial balance is help in checking an arithmetical accuracy of double entry, which means in order to know if you have done well in preparing the double entry, you have to open the trial balance. How do you know if the double entry is correct? Is to see if the double entry is balanced, which means the column of debit column and credit column is equal. You will know the double entry system you have opened is correct. The second advantage, it can be used to prepare the final account or financial statement, because all the information which are obtained from the trial balance are used to prepare the financial statement or the final account. The third one, it can help to detect errors which do affect the trial balance. Third, it helps to detect errors which can affect the trial balance. You will know the error which you have obtained when you prepare the double entry by seeing in the trial balance, by looking on the column which are in trial balance. Which column? The debit column and credit column. You are going to see in the format of the trial balance. the quorum of debit quorum and credit quorum should agree or should be equal to each other. After seeing the advantage of trial balance, let's look on the format of preparing trial balance. Trial balance have got two quorum. The quorum number one is the debit quorum, and quorum number two is the credit quorum. All the balances with a debit balance are listed in the debit quorum, and all ledgers with the credit balances are recorded in the credit quorum. So, after list all the balances which you have obtained from the ledger, you have to totalize each column, and each column should be identical or should be equal, which means the total which you obtain from debit column should be equal with the total which you obtain from credit column. When you prepare the trial balance, you have to take the following notes into consideration. Number one, the total of each of the two columns should be identical, which means the debit column and the credit column. And the second, often the account with zero balances will not be listed, which means the ledger or the accounts which are equal or zero balances are not being recorded in the trial balance. After seeing the advantage of trial balance, let's move to the format of preparing trial balance. First, the trial balance should have the heading which represents the name of the account. Trial balance as at will be given the date of preparing the trial balance. Then trial balance have got the number of ledger, details, debit column and the credit column. The first column we use to record the number of transactions, and the second column, detail column, we use to record the descriptions of transaction or the name of the ledger. And the other column is the debit column and the credit column. Here we use to record the balances of each account or ledger. So, after preparing the trial balance or after posting the balance of each account or ledger, you have to totalize each column, the debit column and credit column. And the debit column should be equal with the credit column, which means the total of debit column should be equal with the total of credit column. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Thank you for watching. See you next session.